everything for me was visual and storytelling. I mean, what I mean by storytelling is akin to what people consider stand-up today, stand-up comedy or stand-up verbal essays. Storytelling, verbal storytelling. That's the tradition that you come from in the old families. People, an old man would come in and tell us stories to keep us quiet. Kids, you know. My mother was very funny. My father was very strict. It was an interesting balance. There was this tension, which, and yet, they're madly in love with each other. And out of the drama of the lives that everyone was leading, and there was drama. Some would consider it melodrama, but melodrama still affects people. I found that the emotional violence was as maybe even more punishing than physical violence. And so I felt it all the time. The only thing I could do was deal with it on film, like a giant piece of sculpture, where you fight with the marble. You fight, you know, you go in there, and it's exciting, and it's an impulse. It just won't stop. Distinct voices of filmmakers have to be supported somehow. They need the financing to make the pictures. They really do. They have to be supported and have to be nurtured by other means. And one has to take advantage as to how to take advantage of the technology and the circumstances. But the most important thing is that the films have got to get made. New people have to be given the support and the money. I mean, anything, if it's $10. You can make, also, what's interesting too is you can make a film on an iPhone. You can make a film on anything. They don't even need that. But where will it be shown? I mean, it's open, I think. It's open, and it's time, there may be, it's time for an open-mindedness to be able to absorb it all and to try to work out something for the benefit, ultimately, of the culture of cinema.